Hello, I'm Pete Donaldson. Now, last year at around about this time, I was in Kisumu in Kenya in an informal settlement taking a look at the problems they have with a high water table right next to Lake Victoria. Right now, I'm in the middle of blooming nowhere, to be quite frank. I'm in Zimbabwe, Western Zimbabwe, and they've got some real issues. It's arid, it's dry, it rains for only a couple of months each year, and they haven't got enough water to be able to grow food, to grow crops, to eat. They're starving and they need our help.
So I found out how small changes make a big difference to the problems that people face here.
Our district is purely rural. We are naturally a dry area, but we now realize we're getting drier each time. The community that we serve, or the populace that we serve, it depend on remittances, subsistence farming. Some household members resort to migrating to neighboring countries in search for work so that they fend for their families. At the end of the day, those children are left to run the home on their own.
I feel bad because I have to look after children, so at least I'm still a child. So it's a little bit hard, but I don't have a choice.
Yeah.
They come once, almost 2 weeks only, and they...
And then they have to go back to go to work.
If there were agricultural industries, maybe they would be working there, but since there are less agricultural industries here, so it's hard for them to come. Mm. Yeah, we plant crops here during the rain seasons.
And you manage this whole thing yourself?
Yeah, we're doing it ourselves with my siblings.
To be honest, I was amazed she could grow anything in that dry, dusty field. I was invited to spend the night with a family that relied on the food that they grow to see how they're managing with the situation. This is Tulani. She's the head of the household and looks after her 99-year-old mother and her grandchildren. She was good enough to cook us a little bit of satsa and okra and put us up for the night. Felt quite guilty taking her food, to be honest, because she's got nothing. She's got absolutely nothing. She's got a little bit of ground, a little bit of soil to grow crops in, but it's just unworkable. The ground's too dry. I'm not very good at this.
Are you doing it? Oh my god. Whoa. You're doing it. Oh. Is it, does it hurt?
No, it's pretty wet. I don't know what I'm doing wrong.
She has to carry water for 2 kilometres and she has to do it 6 times a day, 25 litres a trip, to be able to water the ground and keep the animals alive, let alone have enough water to drink and to cook.
Morning.
Oh. Oh, that was tough.
As the sun started to rise and seeing the children walking to school with no food in their stomachs. They eat once a day because they just don't have enough food. She just wants a chance to grow crops and make her family sort of self-sufficient. We're going to be heading out to see some of the solutions that Practical Action have put in place when it comes to irrigation. Hopefully in the future that could help Tulani and her family get back on their feet.
Hey, I'm Masocha Chalibe. I'm the chairman of the Machowoto Garden here in Tsipula.
We're now currently standing on my second underground river. You can't actually hear this on the recording, but you can actually sort of feel the vibrations and hear the pumps working deep underground. So the actual solar power takes the water from the river, takes it up to that big green tank up there.
Yes.
And then gravity does its business down into the fields itself.
Right,
okay. Are these your cows?
Skip.
Skip.
What kind of vegetables are we growing here?
Tomato, onion.
Tomato, onions.
Mealies.
Oh.
Spinach.
Spinach. Okay, these are some pretty nutritious crops.
Yes, yes.
So, what do you do with these crops?
We feed the family, we sell it in the market, we take our kids to school, you know, everything.
So we're here in front of Mashaba Primary School, a school which has over 340 students, some of whom come from communities which benefit from some of Practical Action's work. We're going to be meeting the head teacher, who apparently rides a really cool motorbike, so I'm really looking forward to meeting him.
Children didn't have breakfast in most of the families. Mm. They used to have only one meal per day. But since the rehabilitation of the irrigations, now the children can have three meals or more. Because when a starving child normally doesn't attend school regularly.
And when they do, they're tired as well.
Yes, because they'll be tired, no energy. Even when they come to school, they have no energy to concentrate because they're hungry.
Yeah.
So because of the connectivity to this sustainable energy, solar generated, so we have seen an improvement in the attendance.
Have you noticed that children are better fed now than they were some years ago?
Previously, we were having about four or five children with malnutrition. The number has dropped.
Presumably, the mothers are a little bit more healthy as well.
Yeah, the mothers are healthy and they give birth to healthy children.
And it's not just the work that Practical Action have done with the solar panels and the water and the pumping. It's also about education, I suppose. The fact that you have to keep working on the land in a certain way, choosing the right crops, choosing the right time to put it in the ground.
Okay, yes, we have got our field officer who usually come and visit us and tell us and teaches us how to do it and the type of medicine that we use to spray the aphids, showing us in the spacing of how to plant these plants. Yeah, it does assist us a lot.
But sometimes money is a problem. You see, they want to.
Yeah.
Because there is a lot of people who are poor, who are starving. But if they come and ask for, you just can't give them.
Yeah.
You give, yeah, you give. So even the elders, you give.
Yeah, so you are sustaining the community, really, in many ways.
Yes.
Have you become friends with the other people who are also farming?
No, we're very, very friendly.
Yeah.
We like each other every day. We do meetings to see what is going wrong, what is going right.
So you've seen the hardship, you've seen the challenges, you've seen the problems here in this part of the world. Here is the solution, all thanks to Practical Action. Donate now before March 8th. Every pound you donate will be matched by the UK government, and your money goes to fund Practical Action projects all around the world. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you for donating.